The Grosvenor turnback of the western branch of the Red Line was ended in December, so it's only fair to end the Silver Spring turnback today as well.
After 29 years, the Silver Spring turnback has officially ended.
It's a win for the metro system, it's a win for riders, it's a win for the environment, and it's a win for the quality of life of thousands of residents of Forest Glen, Wheaton, and Glenmont.
Before the change, the metro would stop every other Red Line train in Silver Spring and turn back to Washington, D.C. Now, the trains will travel all the way to Glenmont.
Well, this is really a historic day for 11,000 riders who board every day at Wheaton, at Glenmont, and at Forest Glen. Every day since those stations have opened, they've been waiting twice as long for a train as the riders in Silver Spring and everybody farther south. And that's not fair. They pay full price, but they get half the service.
Glenmont is my home station. And whether it was going to Catholic University for school or working on Capitol Hill, I've been the Red Line rider my whole life. And I always had to add that extra 30 to 45 minute pad just in case I caught the wrong train that didn't go all the way, or unfortunately we had a lot of service issues.
The Washington Metropolitan Area Transit Authority voted in favor of ending the turnback after attending Councilmember Tom Hucker's town hall earlier this year.
And this is a result of your actions, because I attended a hearing that Tom put together earlier this year in Silver Spring. You're all loud and clear that you wanted an end to the Silver Spring turnback.
We really want to make sure everybody in this area knows they just got a big amenity that they didn't have yesterday. And they really should try Metro again, or, you know, they're going to be pleasantly surprised if they ride it every day. There's going to be trains coming much more often, and they'll be open with more seats available than they have been even, you know, going back the last 20 years.
These changes are that all Metro Rail passes will now come with unlimited Metro bus rides at no additional cost. In addition, the unlimited regional bus pass will drop nearly 15% from $17.50 to $15 for a 7-day pass.
We have made an historic investment in Metro, and it shows what happens when the region comes together to invest in transit.
These are the kind of incremental steps that will get us to that point of saying, yes, we have absolutely reliable transit.
And with progress like this, we can't turn back.
Reporting in Wheaton, I'm Deirdre Byrne for MyMC Media.